In Biggleswade, England, from 1956 to 1960, the Berkeley Company made caravans, and it was the biggest selling caravan maker in the world. Caravan was a little trailer.
A trailer
where you camp in. And it was a seasonal business, and they talked to, I can't think of the names now, but the gentleman who designed this, and he came up with this design. And it basically weighs about 750 pounds. They advertised it got 70 miles to the gallon and went 70 miles an hour.
Now, would this be considered a sports car?
Yes, yeah.
A contemporary...
And they competed with these, and they were very competitive. They only had some of them had a little bigger engine. This has a 328, SE328 is called. It's an Excelsior motorcycle engine, converted for automotive use with a starter and everything. And they made a two-cylinder, and they also made a three-cylinder Excelsior. And they also made a B95, which the top, this is called the B65, because it's about 65 miles an hour is the speed. The B95 would go 95 miles an hour, and they were very competitive. All fiberglass, completely fiberglass, with aluminum metal embedded in the fiberglass to give it more strength. And the whole car only weighs 750 pounds.
Where did you come up with this one?
I saw this one on Craigslist and bought it out of Kansas. And
so is there a cult-like following for this?
There are so few of them. There is a cult following, but it's in England, you know. And they also made these in three-wheelers. And they made a lot of three-wheelers because of the tax breaks in England. And... the engine's probably worth more than the car, because all those guys in England want their three-wheelers and stuff.
So what's going to happen to this eventually?
Well, I plan to get it running and stuff. The cow walked over and busted all that down. I actually pushed it back up and knocked the carburetor, broke that, and I've had that welded. And basically, it should be ready to run. So 37 Nash Twin 8 car is eight cylinder with two spark plugs per cylinder. Spark plugs down both sides of the engine. See the distributor. It's a huge distributor with 18 wires going in. It has two complete electrical systems. Also, it has
an elaborate horn system.
That there is factory. Yeah, and this is the old bells of the bull, you know, move horns. And
now this is... got some advertising on the side.
It was cut down. See, it was the same model as this in an eight cylinder. This is a four-door sedan. This was a four-door sedan they cut down, and he made what he called a fire chief's car out of it. 37 Nash Ambassador Cabriolet, which Cabriolet is a convertible, you know. Cabriolets had roll-up windows. Roadsters had no windows. And this is a Cabriolet, the only open car Nash made. Ronald Reagan, when he was in Nebraska as a radio disc jockey, and he had sent a tape out to, or went to California and sent a tape there before he became an actor, and they called him to come out to California, that they were going to give him opportunities out there or a job. And he bought a 37 Nash Ambassador Twin 6 Cabriolet, and it was white. And celebrities, they all bought Packards and Auburns and Cords and Duesenbergs and stuff, and bankers bought Nashes because they were such a good value and they were really dependable and stuff. We had this up to 80 miles an hour one time, and it doesn't have overdrive, so they were good.
These are Petty's, and they're all signed by George Petty. George Petty was a artist, and he was in Esquire, and he had the Petty girls.
Oh,
you know,
I remember
all
those.
Girls.
Yeah, these.
He designed this for conservative Nash, and he designed these, and they put these on the Nashes from probably 47 to 55, probably.
And we pulled here, the car club had our meeting here. And we started it up and pulled it around, and the steering was so bad, I ran into a tree. Now, those aren't the right headlights anyway. I've got Model T headlights to put on there. So
what year is this again?
1926, 27. I'm not right.
When did they start making Model Ts?
Oh, 1903, I guess.
Oh, okay. So this is
right after they had early in the Model Ns and stuff, and they used that T designation for a long time. Those are the Model T headlights. But we worked on this, and it was his uncle's car, and it was his uncle's dad's car. He would drive it down the hill. It doesn't have a starter. You'd have to roll it to start it.